In this video, we're continuing on with the solving quadratic equations by completing the square worksheet on the KutaSoftware website under the Infinite Algebra 1 section, picking up where we left off with number 9. We're going to start by adding the constant to both sides in order to move it to the right-hand side. So adding 48 to both sides will give us k squared minus 8k equal to a positive 48. Now what we need to do is we need to complete this square that's on the left-hand side. And in order to do that, we know that that b value is a negative 8, and c is equal to b over 2 squared. And our b is negative 8, so I'll have negative 8 over 2 squared, which is a negative 4 squared, which equals a positive 16. So now we're going to add 16 to the left, and we're going to add 16 to the right. So we'll have k squared minus 8k plus 16 equal to 48 plus 16. And we have to add 16 to both sides so that we don't change the overall value of the equation. Whatever we do to the left, we need to do to the right. So k squared minus 8k plus 16 is in the form of a squared minus 2ab plus b squared, where a is k and b is 4. So we'll have k minus 4 squared, a minus b squared, because that equals a squared minus 2ab plus b squared. And then 48 plus 16 equals a positive 64. So our next step will be to take the square root of both sides. So we'll have k minus 4 equal to a positive square root of 64, or the negative square root of 64. So k minus 4 is going to equal a positive 8, or it's going to equal a negative 8. Because negative 8 squared equals positive 64, and 8 squared equals positive 64. So we'll add 4 to both sides in this first equation to get that k is equal to a positive 12. And then we'll add 4 to both sides in that second equation to get that k is equal to a negative 4. So my two solutions in number 9 are 12 and negative 4. Let's continue on to number 10. In number 10, we'll start by adding 63 to both sides. So adding 63 to the left and adding 63 to the right. So we'll have p squared plus 2p equal to a positive 63. Now we need to figure out what that c value is in order to complete this square. If b is a positive 2, then c will equal 2 over 2 squared, which is 1 squared, which equals 1. So we're going to be adding 1 to both sides. So I'll have p squared plus 2p plus 1, and then that's equal to 63 plus 1. P squared plus 2p plus 1, which we can write as a plus b, that quantity squared. So my a value is p, and my b value is a positive 1. So p plus 1 squared equals p squared plus 2p plus 1. And that is going to equal 63 plus 1, which is 64. Now, we'll take the square root of both sides. So p plus 1 is going to equal a positive 8, and p plus 1 is going to equal a negative 8. So I'll take away 1 from both sides in my first equation to get that p is equal to a positive 7. And then I'll take away 1 from both sides in my next equation to get that p is equal to a negative 9, since negative 8 minus 1 equals negative 9. So my solutions in number 10 are a positive 7 and a negative 9. And number 11, even though this doesn't equal 0, that's okay, because we're just going to add 48 to both sides, just like in the previous two problems where we're adding that constant to move it to the other side of the equation. So we'll have m squared plus 2m equal to negative 6 plus 48, which is a positive 42. Now we're going to figure out what the c value is in order to complete the square m squared plus 2m, and then we're going to be adding that c. So if b is equal to a positive 2, c will be equal to 2 over 2 squared, which equals 1 squared, which is 1. So we'll have m squared plus 2m plus 1 equal to 42 plus 1. M squared plus 2m plus 1, we can rewrite as m plus 1 squared. And 42 plus 1 is 43. So I'm going to be taking the square root of both sides. So I'll have that m plus 1 equals the positive square root of 43, and m plus 1 will equal negative square root of 43, since that negative squared is equal to positive 43. And this negative is on the outside of the square root of 43 because we're taking the square root of a positive number. So taking the square root of a positive number will give us a positive solution and a negative solution. So now what I'm going to do is subtract 1 from both sides to get that m equals the square root of 43 minus 1, which I'll just type into my calculator. The square root of 43 minus 1 equals 5.557. So we'll have positive 5.557. And when I subtract 1 from both sides in my other equation, I'll have the negative square root of 43, so that negative answer, and then I'll subtract 1 to get negative 7.5574, which rounds to negative 7.557. So my solutions in number 11 are positive 5.557 and a negative 7.557. Moving on to number 12, I'll start by subtracting that constant 21, essentially moving it to the right-hand side with my other constant of 6. So I'll have p squared minus 8p equal to 6 minus 21, which equals negative 15. Now in order to complete the square, my b value is a negative 8, so my c value will equal negative 8 over 2 squared, which is negative 4 squared, which equals a positive 16. So I'll add 16 to both sides. So p squared minus 8p plus 16 will equal negative 15 plus 16. Now on the left-hand side of my equation, that's in the form of a squared minus 2ab plus b squared, which I can write as a minus b squared. So I'll write this as p minus 4 squared, since b squared, 4 squared is 16, minus 2 times a times b, 2 times p times 4 is 8p, and a squared is p squared. Negative 15 plus 16 is a positive 1. So taking the square root of both sides, I'll get that p minus 4 equals a positive 1, since the square root of 1 is 1, and I'll get that p minus 4 equals negative 1, since negative 1 squared equals 1, so the square root of positive 1 can also equal negative 1. Now I'll add 4 to both sides to get that p equals 1 plus 4, which is 5. And then I'll add 4 to both sides to get that p equals negative 1 plus 4, which is a positive 3. So my solutions in number 12 are 5 and 3. Let's continue on to the second page. In number 13, I'll be subtracting 14 at the start. So I'll have m squared plus 10m equal to negative 7 minus 14, which is a negative 21. So in order to complete the square, my b value on the left-hand side is 10, so c will equal 10 over 2 squared, which is 5 squared, which equals 25. So I'll add c to both sides. So m squared plus 10m plus c will be plus 25, and then I'll have negative 21 plus c, or plus 25. So m squared plus 10m plus 25 can be written, or simplified, as m plus 5 squared. A squared plus 2ab plus b squared equals a plus b squared. And negative 21 plus 25 equals a positive 4. Now, taking the square root of both sides, I'll get that m plus 5 equals a positive 2, and m plus 5 equals a negative 2, since the square root of 4 is positive 2 and negative 2. I'll subtract 5 from both sides to get that m equals a negative 3. 2 minus 5 is negative 3. And then in my other equation, I'll subtract 5 from both sides to get that m is equal to negative 2 minus 5, which is negative 7. So my solutions in 13 are negative 3 and negative 7. Moving on to number 14, I don't have a constant on my left-hand side. It's already been moved to my right-hand side of my equation, so I just need to complete the square. So b is equal to negative 2, therefore c equals negative 2 over 2, b over 2 squared. Negative 2 over negative 2 is negative 1, and when I square that quantity, I'll get a positive 1. So now I'm just going to add c to both sides. B squared minus 2b plus c equals 3 plus c, and that c value was 1. So I'll have v minus 1 squared equal to 3 plus 1, which is 4. Taking the square root of both sides, I'll get that v minus 1 equals positive or negative square root of 4. So v minus 1 equals the positive square root of 4, which is 2, or v minus 1 equals the negative square root of 4, which is negative 2. So I'll add 1 to both sides to get that v is equal to 3, and then I'll add 1 to both sides to get that v is equal to a negative 1. So 3, negative 1 are my solutions in number 14. Now we're going to be moving on to number 15, and 15 we're switching things up a bit. Our a value is no longer 1. So what we're going to do is divide everything by a. So dividing the right-hand side by 5 and dividing the left-hand side by 5. 5v squared divided by 5 is v squared, or 1v squared, which equals v squared, and then we're subtracting 21 over 5. So 21 divided by 5 in decimal form is 4.2, and that's going to equal 10v over 5, which is 2v. So again, 4.2 is 21 divided by 5. So now I'll complete it the same way. However, in order to complete the square, I need x squared plus bx on the same side and my constant on the other side. So essentially, I need to switch this 2v and negative 4.2. So I'll do that by adding 4.2 to both sides, and at the same time, I'll be subtracting 2v from both sides. You can see that negative 4.2 and 4.2 will cancel out on the left, and 2v and negative 2v will cancel out on the right. So I'll get v squared minus 2v equal to a positive 4.2. Now I'm just going to complete the square the same way I've been doing it. My b value is negative 2, and my c value is equal to negative 2 over 2 squared, which is negative 1 squared, which is a positive 1. So now I'm going to be adding 1 to both sides. So I'll have v squared minus 2v plus 1 equal to 4.2 plus 1. V squared minus 2v plus 1 can be rewritten as v minus 1 squared, since my a value is v and my b value is 1, and it's in the form of a squared minus 2ab plus b squared. And that's equal to 4.2 plus 1, which is 5.2. Now I'll take the square root of both sides. So I'll get that v minus 1 equals positive or negative square root of 5.2. So v minus 1 equals the positive square root of 5.2, and v minus 1 equals negative square root of 5.2. So what I'm going to do, I'll add 1 to both sides of each of those equations in order to solve for v. So in the first equation, I'll get v is equal to the square root of 5.2 plus 1, which is 3.280, or 3.28. And then in the second equation, if I have negative square root of 5.2 and I'm adding 1 to that, I'll get a negative 1.28. So v is equal to negative 1.28. So my two solutions in number 15 are 3.28 and negative 1.28. Let's continue on to the last problem that I'll complete in this video, number 16. If you haven't done so already, like and subscribe. So in number 16, we have 4v squared plus 16v equals 65. Because that a value is not 1, I'm going to need to divide by a on both sides. So 4v squared divided by 4 is a positive 1v squared, or simply v squared. And that will be added to 16v divided by 4, which is a positive 4v, and that equals 65 divided by 4, which is 16.25, or 16 and 25 hundredths. Now I need to complete the square on my left-hand side. So my b value is equal to positive 4, and my c value will be equal to 4 over 2 squared, which is 2 squared, since 4 divided by 2 is 2, and 2 squared will equal 4. So when I'm adding c to both sides, I'll be adding 4. V squared plus 4v plus 4 equals 16.25 plus 4. A squared plus 2ab plus b squared will be v plus 2 squared. And that's equal to 16.25 plus 4, which is 20.25. So taking the square root of both sides, I'll get that v plus 2 equals positive or negative square root of 20.25. So that means that v plus 2 equals a positive square root of 20.25, and v plus 2 equals negative square root of 20.25. So subtracting 2 from both sides in each of those equations, I'll solve for v. In my first equation, the square root of 20.25, subtracting 2 from that, I'll get a positive 2.5. And in my second equation, when I subtract 2, if I'm taking it away from a negative square root of 20.25, I'll get negative 6.5. And that's because the square root of 20.25 is equal to 4.5. So 4.5 minus 2, and then negative 4.5 minus 2. That gives me 2.5 and negative 6.5 as my solutions in number 16. If you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments below, and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. And if you haven't done so already, like, subscribe, and share, because all likes, all subscriptions, and all shares are greatly appreciated.